It was quite a career for Lee Stempniak. 14 NHL seasons playing for 10 different teams, 911 games. Lee joins us now, so I'll start off by saying congratulations on an awesome career. And Lee, we were talking to you during the break before we went live, and you said something that I think a lot of professional athletes say once they retire, and that's that it flew by. It went by so fast. So kind of give us an idea of how fast 14 years flies by.
Way too fast. I think that's my feeling. Yeah, thanks a lot for having me on. It's been a wild ride, and it's been a lot of fun playing. Gotten a lot of text messages and phone calls from people that have spanned those 14 years. And I was talking with Matt Stajan, and 10 years ago I got traded to Toronto when we were roommates on the road, and we've been best friends ever since. And it seems like it was yesterday, and now you look back and it's been 10 years. So it's something you never take for granted, and you try and appreciate and live in the moment every day, but it still slips by too quickly.
Lee, what do you remember about the first year in the NHL? I'm sure at that point you were just trying to figure it out and just trying to start a career and hope to play that long. What do you remember about year one?
A lot of uncertainty. Coming out of Dartmouth as a fifth-round pick, I went into training camp and had no idea what to expect, and just sort of hung around and made the opening day roster, played my first game, which was about 4 minutes, played another game, which was 4 minutes, got sent down, and just a lot of up and down. I think the thing that was really hit home was it's hard to establish yourself as an NHL player, and especially as a young player, you're living day to day, and you worry one mistake or one bad game is going to get you sent down, and you think one good play or scoring a goal, no matter how you play, is going to keep you there, and it's a lot of ups and downs. It's a lot of fun. You know, I never traveled. I think I was on an airplane two or three times before my first NHL season, and I got to see a lot of things. But it's the first year for sure was a lot of up and down, a lot of roller coaster, and just a lot of questioning yourself at times.
Lee, where do you go from here? You're 36 years old. You haven't had a lot of time to contemplate it yet. You earned nearly $25 million in your career, obviously well-educated. What does the future look like for Lee Stempniak?
At the moment, just being a father, I've got three young kids who have really given up a lot, and a wife that's been there through everything and allowed this to happen. So right now, being at home, I think I'd like to stay in hockey. Like player development, player personnel, management side, I think really appeals to me. You know, as you know, I've played on 10 different teams and for a number of different coaches and experienced a lot of different things, from playing on a first line to being a healthy scratch and being on waivers. And I think those experiences would lend itself to helping younger players reach the NHL quicker. And I benefited a lot as a player from mentors like Keith Tkachuk and Bill Guerin and Jamal Mayers and Barrett Jackman when I was in St. Louis, and Paul Kariya and people like that. And, you know, that's something I enjoyed later in my career, helping people out with that. And I think that'd be a natural fit, building relationships in a player development type role.
Sounds like you want to pay it forward. So kudos to you on that. You
this
mentioned
is your resume.
I think that's really awesome. Not everyone does that. I think there's something to be said about, you know, lending your experience and what you learn through it to other people and helping them on their journey. But you also mentioned, you know, you got a ton of text messages and phone calls. I'm sure they're still coming in. Is there anybody that reached out to you this week that maybe took you by surprise?
No, I mean, I've been fortunate to play with a lot of great people, a lot of great teammates, and I've kept in touch with a lot of people. The first person for sure was my strength coach, Matt Nichol of BioSteel fame, who called right away, and he's been a great friend and really helped me along in this journey. And I had a great talk with my college coach, Bob Gaudette, last night, who was instrumental in me going from just being happy to be a college player to making the NHL. So things like that, where it sort of comes full circle and you get to thank the people that helped you along the way, has been really special.
You know, Lee, you mentioned you played at 10 different teams. Where do you think was your favorite place to play?
Yeah, CJ, I'm so glad you asked this. And before you answer, I'm going to remind you that you're retired now. So you don't have
That's right.
play the politics.
Right.
You can be honest now and tell us your favorite place to play.
Yeah, there were... I mean, I know it's cliche, a lot of different things. And I liked playing in New Jersey a lot. It was a great organization. I had a good year there personally, and really enjoyed that. You know, the original six teams was certainly something that was very memorable. Probably personally, I enjoyed Calgary. Just it was a really close-knit team. There were a lot of guys around my age who are really good friends still, like Mark Giordano, Mike Camilleri, Dennis Wiedemann, Matt Stajan, and our wives got along. We all got along, and it was a great place to play. So from that point of view, I think Calgary is right up there.
Lee, as you look back, you're one of 20 players from the 03 draft. I know you said you were a fifth-round pick, but think about that. You're one of 20 players to have played in excess of 900 games.
Wow.
I have a tremendous amount of respect for you. I know what goes into a career, and I want to say congratulations, obviously. But tell the fans on a little lighter note, what is the one thing that you absolutely won't miss about being a professional hockey player? What did you hate the most about the job?
The conditioning testing, training camp testing for sure. No matter how hard I worked or how good a shape I was in, I'm just not a tester. There's guys that can just gut it out and get the score better than probably what they deserve. I'm one of those guys that probably under test. So I'd have that knot in my stomach no matter what before training camp testing every day. And once that day was over, I just put it behind me and was happy for 364 more days. I didn't have to do anything like that.
I love that. Honesty from Stempniak here on NHL Now. I'm sure there's a lot of people that would probably agree with you.
Yeah. Lee, you got some time. Come on down here to Secaucus. Jump in with us a little bit. We can learn from some of the experience that you've had. So we'd love to see you down here if you're
good. You're always welcome.
Thank you very much. And thanks to you guys, too, for making the game more accessible and showing people's personalities. It's great. And I think it's awesome now that the fans get to see more of the players, and it's not just a helmet and a mask.
There you go. Well, listen, Lee, all the best, and hopefully we'll hear from you down the road.
All right. Thank you, guys.